Spirit.
This day, Lord, the church protects herself from the vegetable fields to represent how much nearer we are to the manger of Bethlehem, but also represents our joy, a gift that nothing can take away in this world, for to remind that God loves us even in the midst of pandemic and civil unrest, that God reminds us that He loves us, He holds our hand, and brings us close to Himself. In addition, at the same sacrifice in the Mass, we're grateful for the presence of a dear friend, from the Luke Lakes to the Franciscan Friars of Renewal, who I believe, who I know, will preach to us on God's joy and love in His life and in all our lives. My brothers and sisters, let us call to mind our standards. So let us prepare to celebrate the sacred.
Thank you.
St. Paul to Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice always. Pray without ceasing. In all circumstances, give thanks. For this is the will of God for you in Christ Jesus. Do not quench the Spirit. Do not despise prophetic utterances. Test everything. Retain what is good, and refrain from every kind of evil. May the God of peace make you perfectly holy, and may you entirely, spirit, soul, and body, be preserved blameless for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The one who calls you is faithful, and he will also overcome.
Thanks be to God.
The gospel of the Lord. And this is one of those places you walk in and you say, I am Rome. You're just so beautiful, you know. And you do, you have to say, when you look at a building like this, you know, this is the thing, we call the church, oh, there's the building, the church, and then there's the church, right? The people in the building, the people that have been baptized. And they're not so separate. This is a place that you provided for and you made your home, and you are reflected in the beauty of this place, and the beauty of this place reflects you. And so I just want to honor that and reverence that as we begin. Tonight we're told that we should rejoice. Father proclaimed it very powerfully. We should rejoice at the beginning of Mass. I felt that. I'm sure you did too. And he admitted it. In the midst of the pandemic, in the midst of social unrest, yet still to rejoice is the message that's given to us. Does that resonate with us? Or does that kind of, is there some dissonance? You know, we say, oh, that kind of bounces off me, you know, a little bit tonight. And it's okay, which I think it's a better thing, it's an honest thing for us to say, these are the reasons, Lord, why that message of rejoicing bounces off me. Having trouble receiving it tonight. That's a good thing, to acknowledge that before God. The word in our first reading which stood out to me, it said, to rejoice in the Lord heartily. Heartily. When is another time that we use that word heartily? Think about it. When's another time as Catholics we say heartily?
Thank you.
On the Feast of One Day, in fact, we pray at the beginning of Mass that we would heed, that we would live the counsels of Our Lady of Guadalupe and One Day. I had to stop and say, well, what are the counsels of Our Lady of Guadalupe? You know, Fatima is so clear, there's these secrets and these different things and lords and the message maybe is more in our mind. What are the counsels of Our Lady of Guadalupe? Well, there's Juan Diego. He's worried about his uncle, Juan Bernardino, who's sick and dying, and he's rushing off to go get a priest so he can come back and hear the uncle's confession and give him the last rites before he dies. So Juan Diego knows he has to go and do that. He's moving. But he also knows that Our Lady's going to meet him on the mountain. So what does he do? He tries to go around the other side of the hill to avoid Mary. And as he does so, she shows up anyway. She was not that smarted by him, right? And so she meets him on the other side of the mountain. She says, my little one, you know, where are you going? Why are you so troubled? She says, don't you know that you're here in the fold of my heart? And brothers and sisters, God is the counsel of Our Lady of Guadalupe. Do you know that I'm your mother? That I am here, that you are in my eyes, that I see you, that in seeing you, I know you. Everything, your concerns. Juan Diego is concerned for his uncle. He's going to get a priest. Bring the priest back to the confession. Last phrase. That's a good thing. That's a good thing to be worried about, right? And Our Lady of Guadalupe, have no fear. This disease is not going to take your uncle. She shows up to the uncle and gives him. Juan Diego goes to the bishop, brings the sign, and we have this image printed on his stone of his mantle. The church is built in a place. Juan Diego lives a simple life, sweeping up the church, lives on a little hut, connected to old chapel, other buildings, so simple life, retelling the story over and over again. What is the counsel of Our Lady of Guadalupe? What did Juan Diego tell all the people that came to see the image? As he basically struck the church and welcomed the pilgrims, he sent his mother to tell us that tenderness. In a visceral way, she pulled us in her arms. So, brothers and sisters, what is that stuff, you know? What is that stuff that kind of bounces off of us right now? ministry to me uses the words looking about the complexities of life.